Hi and welcome back to another Amp Dyno video. This video features a 1997 Rockford Fosgate Punch 200.2. They made a design change in 1997. Rockford was introducing the Darth Vader style amplifier range. The amplifier is rated 2 times 100 watts into a 4 ohm load. I tested continuous power into a 1 ohm load per channel and dynamic power into a 1/2 ohm per channel. On this side you have the RCA inputs, a gain knob for each channel and also the speaker terminals. And you have 2 knobs for the bass boost at 45 Hz and treble. If you want to use the amplifier in bridge mode, you just have to connect the positive connector from the left channel and the negative connector for the right channel. Then the amplifier is working in bridge mode. Here on this side you have the battery plus the ground and the remote jack, and there's only one LED as a power indicator. This range also features the X cards to use the amplifier in low pass mode, high pass mode or full pass mode. The amplifier is connected to my power supply and I start with an 8 ohm mono load to get the output power into a 4 ohm load per channel, both channels driven into full power. Continuous power test, 1 kHz. It says 65.6 volts. I go to the top of the waveform. We can calculate with 65.2 volts. The Punch 200.2 delivers 136 watts into a 4 ohm load per channel, both channels driven. Here you see the amplifier's idle current. It's around 1.2, 1.3 amps. And now I give full input signal, continuous power. The amplifier pulls 29.8 amps. I calculated an efficiency of 66.9%. Continuous power test, but this time with 50 Hz input signal. It says we have a peak voltage of 65.6 volts. I'm going to check my cursor position. This is my cursor. Okay, let's be fair and calculate with 64.8 volts. With a 50 Hz input signal, the amplifier delivers 134.6 watts into a 4 ohm load per channel, both channels driven. Dynamic power test, 1 kHz, 20 cycles. I check if all cycles are at the same voltage level, that's the case. And I check the peak voltage, 66.4. And I go to the last cycle. Let's calculate with 66 volts. There's almost no dynamic headroom. With 20 cycles, the amplifier delivers 139.6 watts into a 4 ohm load per channel. Dynamic power test with 8 cycles, 1 kHz. I'm going to the last cycle. I observe the last cycle, that's fair. It says 66.8 volts. With 8 cycles, the amplifier delivers 143 watts into a 4 ohm load per channel. Now I'm testing the amplifier's output power for just 1 millisecond. So lots of distortion is allowed in this test. And we have one cycle. It says 70.4 volts. I go to the top. Okay, let's calculate with 70.4 volts. For just 1 millisecond, the amplifier delivers 158.8 watts into a 4 ohm load per channel. And now I connected a 4 ohm load bridged mono to the amplifier to get the output power into a 2 ohm load per channel, both channels driven. Continuous power test, 1 kHz. And it's 58 volts. The amplifier delivers 215.6 watts into a 2 ohm load per channel, both channels driven. Let's have a look at the amplifier's efficiency. How many amps will it pull out of my power supply if it's bridged mono? 4 ohms.
51.4 amps. The amplifier's efficiency is 61.7%. 50 Hz input signal, 2 ohms per channel. volts. The amplifier delivers 203.9 watts into a 2 ohm load per channel, both channels driven. Dynamic power test, 20 cycles, 1 kHz. All cycles are at the same voltage level. I observe the last cycle. And we have a peak voltage of 59.6 volts, 227.7 watts into a 2 ohm load per channel, both channels driven. 8 cycles into a 2 ohm load per channel. Looks like this. Burst, pause, burst, pause. I go to the last cycle. And we have a peak voltage of 62 volts, 246.4 watts into a 2 ohm load per channel, both channels driven. And the dynamic burst test with just one cycle. Let's calculate with 67.2 volts. For just 1 millisecond, the amplifier is able to put out 289.5 watts into a 2 ohm load, both channels driven. 2 ohms mono connected to the amplifier. The amplifier is not rated to handle 2 ohms mono, that means 1 ohm per channel. But I think dynamically it's not a problem because the power cube back in the days also tested every Rockford amplifier into a 1 ohm load per channel with 20 cycles. Continuous power test, 1 kHz into a 1 ohm load per channel. Try to increase my input signal, there's a protection. So we have some power, I have to calculate. And we calculate with 44.8 volts. Surprise, the amplifier is able to put out some more output power, delivers 250.9 watts into a 1 ohm load per channel, both channels driven into full power. Let's have a look how many amps the amplifier will pull out of my power supply. 77.2 amps. I have 13.52 volts. If I'm testing with continuous power into a 1 ohm load, the efficiency of the amplifier goes down to 48%. Continuous power 50 Hz. I try to squeeze out some more. Oh, it looks bad. I reduce my input signal until we have a clean signal again. Looks nice. We can calculate with 44 volts. The amplifier delivers 242 watts of continuous power with a 50 Hz input signal into a 1 ohm load per channel, both channels driven into full power. Dynamic power test, 20 cycles, 1 kHz. All cycles at the same voltage level. It's always fair to take the last one. Let's calculate with 49.6 volts in this case. With 20 cycles, the amplifier delivers 307.6 watts into a 1 ohm load per channel, both channels driven into full power. Dynamic power test with 8 cycles, 1 kHz. There we have our last cycles. I go up with my input signal. Try to squeeze out some more until we get clipping. Oh, there comes some more. There's my clipping point. I reduce until I have a cleaner output. Let's take this. The amplifier delivers 359.1 watts into a 1 ohm load per channel, both channels driven into full power. And now let's have a look what the amplifier can put out with 1 kHz and for just 1 millisecond. Absolute peak RMS output power. And I increase. There's my clipping point. Ah, that looks bad. I go back. Let's take this just for fun. And I got a peak voltage of 65.6 volts. The amplifier delivers 538 watts into a 1 ohm load per channel. That means more than 1000 watts into a 2 ohm mono load. And now, just for fun, this is a 1 ohm resistor, and I connected this 1 ohm resistor bridged mono to the amplifier. That means I'm testing a 1/2 ohm per channel, both channels driven into full power, and I will start with just 1 millisecond. And let's have a look if the amplifier can put out something. I increase input signal. Oh, still voltage grows. Oh, not bad. Okay, we can take this for fun. And I got a peak voltage of, let's calculate, with 59.2 volts. That's impressive. The amplifier delivers 876.4 watts into a 1/2 ohm per channel, both channels driven. That means bridged mono, 1 ohm, it delivers 1752.8 watts, but for just 1 millisecond. So I go further, and now I'm testing with an 8 millisecond burst. 8 millisecond burst test, 1 kilohertz. I try to increase my input signal. Amplifier is doing something. And I observe the last cycle. Still output power. Oops. Try to squeeze out some more. Oh, it goes bad now. I reduce input signal until we have a clean output voltage. Let's take this. Let's calculate with 38.8 volts. We still get some more watts out of the amplifier with a 1/2 ohm per channel. In this case, the amplifier delivers 376.4 watts into a 1/2 ohm per channel, both channels driven. So I'm surprised a little bit. Dynamic power test with 20 cycles and 1 kilohertz. All cycles at the same voltage level. That's nice. Amp is still running. I go to the last cycle. And let's have a look if it's still clean. Doesn't look too good, but we can just for fun use this maximum voltage. Let's calculate with 36.4 volts. With 20 cycles, the amplifier delivers 331.3 watts into a 1/2 ohm per channel, both channels driven into full power. So this amplifier really surprised me. 1/2 ohm per channel, and the wattage goes higher. All I had to do with this amplifier was to adjust the idle current. It was way too high at 2.3 amps, and now it's 1.2 to 1.3 amps.
And if you like this video, why not leave a thumb, subscribe, or tell your friends? Thanks for watching, and see you next time for one of the next Amp Dyno videos. Bye bye!